All right, if you're looking to verify your domain with Facebook Business Manager, this video is for you. And if you want to know how to do it, I'm going to show you, but just a really, really brief background on what's happening. Now, over the years, there's been a lot of changes with more consumers wanting to control their data. So one of the ways the creator of this phone, Apple, is trying to give more consumers their ownership of their data is by making people that use these devices and have applications on these types of devices hit a prompt that says, and I'll put a photo right here of what it might look like for you if you're on Facebook or if you're on Instagram. And what you're seeing now is that these places are saying, we want you to have your information. And we want you to know that if Facebook or Instagram or any place is actually giving your data that you're not aware of, we want you to click a button. So in order to do that, Facebook has to comply with some tracking framework that Apple's coming out with. Now, that might be more than you wanted to know, but I wanted you to understand that it really kind of comes down to you and your data and making sure that you're aware of what you're doing. So in order for Facebook to be in compliance with that, they're saying we need you to actually update and verify you're the owner of a website. So whatever your domain is, you're the owner of that website, and there's certain things we're gonna need you to start doing. And one of that is verifying your domain, and then after verifying your domain, setting up some events. In this video, I'm just gonna go over verifying your domain, and in another video I'll go over how you can set up your event. So let's go ahead and jump over to the screen and get this done. And by the way, if you like this kind of content, go ahead and click that like button and subscribe. It lets me know what you like and what I need to continue making more of to keep you people out there very happy. All right, let's go ahead and jump in. As you see part of my screen, and that's just for security reasons. I don't want to show all my ad accounts for my clients that I have and all the pages that they have. But I will scoot this over later, but for now, this is what you see. What you want to click is this bottom gear. Now, I'm inside of Facebook Business Manager, and you can even see there by the domain that I'm at, it says business.facebook.com. If you did the video that I recorded about the Facebook Pixel, there I recommended you go ahead and make sure that you're signed up for your Facebook business account. So once you're signed up for your Facebook business account, you go inside, you go to your settings, and you can see we're under business settings. What we want to do here is go to brand safety, click on domains, and then now what we're going to do is add some domains here. Now, I do have a couple domains already verified. One is blurred out because that's for a customer, but that's my other website. So what I'm gonna do now is add a website, and simple as this. It says add a domain. You type in the domain. Don't put www or https, or you don't need any of that. You just need to put in the domain without any of the other information and just click add domain. As soon as I click add domain, it's going to give me this scary red text that says not verified. Well, that's okay. We have three different ways we can verify. We can do it with a meta tag verification, an HTML file upload, which is the fastest and easiest if you have FTP access. If you don't have FTP access, well, I'm going to show you a way that will work for you as well. You can always use DNS, a way to add it to your DNS record, which can also be easy if you have access to where you purchased your domain. And you would come in there and you create something called a text record. You would then give it a value or you would let it know what it's pointing to. That at symbol just means it's your domain name. And then you would just give it this value, what you would do. So this takes a little bit longer according to this. It says 72 hours. So we're going to try this meta tag first. Just to get it up and running, I'm going to be doing this on a WordPress website. You could do this on any website where you have access to the header code. So even if you're using Kajabi or other type of website platforms that will give you a place to edit a template for the header, well, you can use this. So the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and click right here where it says copy to clipboard. I'm just going to copy that. So now it's copied to my clipboard. Then I'm going to go to my website. So this is my website, webchamps.net. So I'm going to go to my website. I'm already logged in. It's a WordPress website. And I'm going to add a new plugin. I go to plugins and add new. There's a million different ways that we can do this. I don't even have to use a plugin. But for the majority of you, this might be the easiest way that you can edit your header code. So if you know how to edit your header code without adding a plugin, by all means do that. But if you don't, here we go. Header footer is what we're gonna type in. Header footer. And actually the one I want is already right there, but I'll just type it in anyways. It's this one by 99Robot. It says header footer code manager. All I'm gonna click is install now. And as it's installing, I'll just give you a quick reminder, and it already says activate, so we'll just click on activate, is that if you have another way, so if you're doing this with Divi or another type of theme that lets you access that code, you don't have to do what we're doing now. But what we did is we went and found a plugin that's gonna let us add that code from Facebook to your website. Once we add that code to your website, then we can go back to Facebook and say, hey, we've done what you asked, now verify our website. So now that we've installed it, it showed that the plugin is activated, which is what I wanted. So I installed it, then I activated it. And it's right here where it says HFCM, Header Footer Code Manager. We're gonna add a new snippet, and snippet name, we'll call this, what are you gonna call this? We're gonna call this Facebook Verify. Yeah, that's fast and easy. We want to make sure it displays site-wide. So every single page we want this to show. We don't want to exclude any pages. We're not going to exclude any post. The header is where we want it. We don't want it in the footer. We want it in the header. We want it to show on all devices and we want it active. So all I'm going to do now is just post this code from Facebook. Snippet code and I click save. Now, once it's saved, I'm going to go back to Facebook. I'm going to cross my, and actually I'm going to do one thing. So if your website, I'm going to go ahead and click this button that says purge cache for all pages. This might not be something that you have to do for your website, but just keep in mind that if you go back to Facebook and it doesn't work immediately, it could be because your website is saving a version of your website, which we call caching. So that when someone comes there, they don't have to download everything, but there's a saved version of your website that helps it load faster. So that's why I'm actually, I just purged my cache to get rid of it. And hopefully now, without updating or reloading this, we're just gonna go ahead and click, make sure we're clicked on meta tag verification. We're gonna click verify, and we're gonna see if that turns green. All right, as you can see, with just what I showed you, our website is now verified, and it gives me a great message saying it's verified. So now that it's verified, I can add partners. So let's say that you have a company and your IT team does this for you first, or if you're doing it yourself, you're now done, and I'm gonna shoot a separate video if you need to actually edit the events. But at this point, you can see your website is verified. Now we need to go ahead and go to the next step, which is how you can actually get these events and make sure everything else is set up. Okay, now that your business is verified with Facebook, you're done. Congratulations. We just have to do a few more steps, but if you have any questions about this, if that didn't work, what we just went through, go ahead and drop a comment below and I'll make sure to respond to get you on the right route. But this is the first step in making sure that you're ready for the changes that are coming out with Apple. I hope this is helpful for you. I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.